Showbiz kwentuhan.
That was the very first sequence I shot for Ironheart.
Joshua Garcia, napaka-professional itong tao.
Kulitan, kasama ang trending celebrities at kinakikiligang love teams ngayon.
Beautiful lies.
Aking mahal.
Sagot na namin yan.
Ako ba yun?
Alam nyo yan dito sa Kapamilya Chat. Hindi ko talaga naiisip na magkaka-award.
All you have to do is sit back, relax, enjoy, and watch your favorite artista sa aming mga pina-level up na challenge at exclusive pasilip sa kanilang buhay sa likod ng camera. Tara na! Dahil bukod sa Zoomustahan, kami nagbabalik studio na.
Oh my God, iiyak ba ako?
Uy! Ang galing mong empleyado ng ABS-CBN.
Nood na sa Kapamilya Chat!
What's up, Kapamilya all over the world? Ako po si Jerry Maya and welcome back to Kapamilya Chat. Mga Kapamilya, we are now streaming via chat.abs-cbn.com at syempre napapanood na din tayo sa ating official Facebook and YouTube pages. Happy, happy Friday sa lahat ng ating mga Kapamilyang nakatutok this afternoon. At syempre Kapamilya, bago tayo nagsimula kanina, napanood na nga natin ang trailer sa pinakabagong series na hatid sa atin ng Viva One. Walang iba kundi ang Safe Skies Archer. Kaya naman, Kapamilya, to join us this afternoon, makakasama natin ang dalawa sa mga cast ng upcoming series na to. I-welcome natin live here on Kapamilya Chat. We have Hyacin Calyado and Jairus Aquino. Hello guys, what's up? Hello!
Hi everyone, it's Hyacin Calyado. I hope everyone is having a really good day so far.
Ayun, sorry naman, Haya.
It's okay, no.
Jai, your turn, brother.
Ayan, it's been a while since nasabi ko to. Pero ayan, magandang hapon sa inyo lahat, mga kapamilya. It's been a while since makabalik sa Kapamilya Chat and I'm happy to be with you guys this afternoon. And sana mag-enjoy lang tayo ngayong tanghali. And ayun, I'm just happy to be here and to say Kapamilya once again.
Totoo. Isa sa mga napaka-sipag mag-promote ni si Jairus sa Kapamilya Chat before kapag may mga ganap yan, automatic nagkakapamilya chat. Pero this time around, first of all, congratulations Jairus and Hyacin for your upcoming series, none other than the Safe Skies Archer. Can you guys share what is this all about? Last week, we've had Krisha and Jerome. We were able to talk about the series. Now, we are curious kung ano ba yung mga character niya dito sa series. Without spoiling, please share to our kapamilyas. Aya.
So, I play Elise Ledesma, Amora Elise Ledesma. I am the younger half-sister of Sean, which is who Kuya Jairus plays. And in this show, you'll see that my character, she's very spoiled, and she has, like, the biggest crush on Hero, who Jerome plays.
Jairus, ikaw naman.
So, me, I'll be playing the role of Sean De Kyle Lopez, or also known as Sean. I'll be Hyacin's stepbrother, older stepbrother. And I'll be playing also the love interest of Nicole O'Neill, which is... She'll be playing the role of Kiera. And yung ako din, yung isa ko pang role for that is I'll be best friend of Jerome Porto, which is here.
You know, best friend. And at the same time, stepbrothers and sisters kayo ng character ni Aya dito sa series.
Yes.
Pero without spoiling, kasi this is the second part of the university series, second book na. What is this all about naman, yung Safe Skies Archer?
Safe Skies Archer is about the story of two people who are really different. Sobrang different sa isa't isa. Like, we all know for sure na na-explain rin ni Christian Jerome na she's out and loud person, you know? Kasi Jerome naman is, well, ano din naman siyang tao? Kasi best friend ko siya, party rin naman kami. Pero siya yung reserve lang na parang somehow... may principles na tao, yung very ano lang, straightforward lang na tao naman. So, very different. And yun, yung relationship nila is mag-iikot towards their, you know, label. Kumbaga sa relationship nila, is sila ba talaga, o ano lang ba talaga sila, and so on so forth.
And that's what we should watch out for, no?
Yes.
Jairus's character, the best friend of Hiro, and at the same time, si Hyacinth naman, her character has a huge crush on Hiro naman, diba? Yeah. Pero, how was it like working with the rest of the cast? Are you guys friends prior this project, or dito talaga kayo nag-get to know?
Yeah, I met everyone for the first time. So, yeah, I haven't worked on any projects with any of them in the past, but it's been very nice because we all clicked very quickly.
First time to work with everyone. Jai, sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, sorry. Ako naman, syempre iba, nakasama ko naman with Heaven, Marco, nakasama ko naman as ABS, and some of other people, Gab as well. You know, nakasama ko si Gab sa lahat ng mga celebrity games sa labas. And pati sa gym, si Gab kasama ko. So, most of them naman nakatrabaho ko na, pero yung iba first time ko nakatrabaho, since it's really higher, my little sister. So, ngayon pa lang talaga kami nagkasama. But, again, like what I've said sa mga past interviews, we never really felt like we're an outsider or just additional dun sa buong, book. Kasi parang, they welcomed us as their own family and friends. Like, we already existed dun sa unang book, no? So it was really parang grateful naman na talagang they welcomed us, even the staff, kasi it's the same staff dun sa book one, kaya wala na rin iba talaga sa mga naramdaman namin. And then si Haya, she's really humble, she's really kind person, no? Talagang wala, she's easy to get along with. Yun nga lang, nag-English kasi si Haya.
Yun nga, nagulat ako kanina, English speaking pala si Haya.
I'm so sorry.
No, it's fine. Haya, what was your first impression to Jairus when you first met on the set?
we first.
Ayan na nga.
I'm kidding. We first met actually at the movie premiere for the Ship Show.
Oh yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay.
So this was before we started shooting. I remember. I call him Kuya. He's been very kind. Like, I remember I was like really nervous backstage because it was like my first movie premiere, but already he was already very kind with me, and like he was helping me out. He was like helping to comfort me and reassuring me like what's gonna happen and stuff like that. So my first impression was okay. No, I'm kidding. I mean, I don't know. I love Kuya. My he's good.
Pero hi, how was your adjustment period working with the cast and everyone? Kumbaga, you are new into the business talaga. Your adjustment, kamusta?
Yeah, it's honestly, I've been saying this in a lot of past interviews. It's been kind of overwhelming because everything's been happening a lot, very fast. A lot of attention came to me so quickly that I didn't really expect. So I've just been trying to navigate through that. But I'm very grateful because the whole team, like the cast and everyone, they've, as we've said, we've connected very fast and quickly, and everyone's just very supportive. And so like this whole experience has just been feeling like a very good learning experience for me, and everyone, it feels like everyone has each other's back. So it's been
wow. Pero let's hear from someone who grew up in showbiz talaga, no? Mr. Jairus Aquino, na bata pa lang tayo, napapanood na natin si Jai. Ano yung advice na ibinibigay mo sa mga newbies like si Haya? Kapag alam mo yun, syempre nandun pa sila sa adjustment period. Yung advice na binibigay mo sa mga, kumbaga, baguhan sa industry?
Sabi ko sa kanila, if kulis yung sabi ko naman, if off camera, you just have to be yourself. You don't have to pretend to be anyone else. Kailangan ito ako para magustuhan nila ako, para makasabay ako. And actually, beforehand, he messaged me, nasabi niya sa akin, "This is my first interview, Kuya, with everything. Sorry, lalaglag na kita, Haya." Pero, sabi ko sa kanya, no, just feel free. You know, just say what you wanna say. Don't pressure yourself out. And it's gonna be easy. It's gonna be easy as 1, 2, 3 lang naman, sabi ko sa kanya. So, sobrang madali lang yan. It's gonna, andyan din naman ako, akong bahala sa'yo. Tulungan kita along the way. So, yun lang. And work-wise naman, just be humble with the people around you. You know, kailangan masarap kang kasama. Kailangan maayos ka makisama sa lahat ng tao. May it be staff, may it be your co-actors, may it be the director, or even the crew. Dapat humble ka lang. Just humble yourself. And just do your best sa lahat ng gagawin mo. And, you know, hindi mo mapapansin na kapag adjust ka na pala dun sa panibagong environment na meron ka every time. Kasi every project, it's also para kind of adjusting pa talaga eh. Especially pag iba yung katrabaho mo, on and off cam. So, basta you just humble yourself and do your best. Yun lang. Yun lang. And know what you're gonna do. Kailangan bago ka dumating sa set, alam mo na yung gagawin mo. Alam mo na yung trabaho mo. Yeah.
Galing. Be real, di ba? Authentic and be humble as always. Yeah, no? Pero going back to your characters dito sa Safe Skies Archer, what do you think is the best trait and the worst trait of your character, if meron man?
For me, I think how unfiltered my character is. I think that's both her best and worst trait.
Being unfiltered.
Yeah, because it's good because it shows that she knows where she stands. She knows her own opinions and thoughts and everything, but sometimes it can come off as like a little too harsh, you know. But it's something that a lot of people admire and love about her, which makes sense. I like that about her too, honestly. Like, it helped me learn a lot.
Being unfiltered, sometimes we can call it as the best and sometimes the worst because you are sometimes beyond what you should have said talaga, diba? So,
yeah.
Ayun, minsan good or bad na talaga yung pagiging unfiltered. No? Pero how about for Jairus naman, your character?
So sa akin, I don't know if pwede to sa YouTube or Facebook, pero label, fuckboy, yun yung worst trait ng character.
Oh.
So, he's just parang happy go lucky getting along with things, no? Parang no strings attached sa tao. So, kahit sino makasalamuhan yung tao, ganun siya. Pero, kapag sa malapit niya ng mga tao, we say hero, sobrang loyal siya, makaibigan, and same goes with Hyacinth, same goes with Elise, sobrang ano siya, sobrang loving niya na kuya talaga, sobrang protective, as in, siya yung typical model kuya na magugustuhan ng lahat, parang ganun. And nung time na rin naman na parang nagseryoso na siya towards Kiera, yun din, iba rin yung loyalty, iba rin yung pagmamahal niya na pinapakita at pinibigay niya din sa character ni Kiera. So, yun yung best and worst so far, yung pagiging fuckboy playboy niya lang talaga.
Pero curious ako, no, kung ano yung magiging papel ng role ni Jairo sa kay Hero talaga. Kasi knowing Hero, si Jerome Schneer niya last time na very career-oriented, very driven, straightforward talaga. So, paano makaka-apekto yung ganong trait ng character ni Jai kay Hero talaga dito sa series, no? Pero,
exactly, siya, yeah.
Diba? Pero itong series na to, Hero is a pilot, then si Yana naman is a flight attendant. Kayo ba, growing up, did you guys see yourself working in the aircraft, ganun, parang FA as pilot, ganyan?
Not really, but I have always imagined what it would be like if I became like a stewardess. I feel like it seems really cool being able to just travel around the world with your job. Mm-hmm.
Ako, it's really been my dream talaga to become a pilot. Up to now, andun pa rin yung dream na maging piloto. Yeah.
Wow.
Ever since I was a kid, I really wanted to be a pilot. So up to now, andun pa rin yung pangarap na yun na, syempre, again, maybe it's not too late for me. Kahit medyo hindi na tayo bumabata, pero again, medyo hindi pa naman siguro that late, pero yun, isa yun sa mga talagang pangarap ko is to become a pilot talaga.
Totoo yun. It's never too late naman for anyone talaga to achieve and reach for their dreams talaga. No? Pero, what can you say as your, kumbaga, takeaway from this series, Safe Skies Archer, as well as from your characters?
One of the things that I guess would be my takeaway is that if it's the right person for you, no matter what happens, no matter what you go through or what puts, like, what gets in between the two of you and your relationship, if it's meant to be, they will definitely come back for you.
Talking about the one, no? Kung bagay yun yung parang concept ng the one, no? Ano man mangyari talaga? Kung kayo-kayo talaga sa isa't isa. No? Jairus, ikaw naman.
Actually, same. Kasi yun talaga somehow yung parang magiging story na itatakal or lesson somehow. I mean, I don't want to spoil everybody, pero siguro I'll just be brief as katulad na lang niya. Na if it's really meant to be, diba, it will be. And kahit pagbalik-balik tayo yung mundo, kung talagang para kayo, para talaga kayo. Ayun.
Yan ang dapat natin abangan mga kapamilya dito sa upcoming series nila. No? Kaya naman, Kaya, Jai, please invite our kapamilyas to watch your upcoming series, Safe Skies Archer. Go ahead.
Save Skies Archer is streaming on Vivo One this coming November 20. It's only like 4 days left. Wow. I'm really looking forward for everyone to see all of the work that we've put into this show. You'll definitely cry. It's beautiful.
Ooh. Thanks, Haya. Jai, ikaw naman.
Yes, I'm inviting everybody, mga kapamilya, to please do support and watch Save Skies Archer on Vivo One this coming November 20. Marami kayong alam pupulot, especially sa mga teenagers dyan. It's actually still a series of all ages pa rin somehow kasi siyempre kahit medyo may edad naman na pwede pa rin namang kiligin mo. Pero for the teenagers talaga, marami kayo lessons matututunan. You'll really enjoy these series. And I hope na sana kung ano yung suporta na binigay nyo sa 3, ganun din sa Safe Skies and all the books na darating pa.
Yes. Again, on November 20, mga kapamilya, Safe Skies Archer on Viva One app. Ayan na nga sa lahat ng kapamilya natin na nakatutok and watching via Facebook Live. Lipat na po kayo sa ating official YouTube or sa ating website dahil we have lots of games for Hyacinth and Jairus. Kapamilya, lipat na and we'll see you guys there. Bye! Alright, diretso na tayo. This time around for our first challenge, we'll be calling it a Two Truths and a Lie Challenge. So for this challenge, you just have to say any three stuff about you. The two of them should be fact and the other one should be the lie. And the other person should guess which one is the lie. Alright? Let's start.
Okay, go Haya.
Oh, ladies first now, Haya. Go ahead.
Okay, my two truths. Oh my god, wait. I have to think about this. My two truths and a lie.
Go ahead.
I used to hate cats. I used to do ballet. And I need to think about this. I used to hate cats. I used to do ballet. And I...
Alam mo, magaling ako dito.
I'm
pressuring you, Haya. Yeah, I'm pressuring you. I'm really good at this. I'm telling you.
I don't know. I feel like this is really good, but I'm trying to think of the third one.
Go.
I really love sweets.
You know what? The third one.
What?
You're the third one is a lie.
Oh.
Why?
You know why?
Why?
Kasi tagal mo siya pinag-isipan. So if it's a fact, you don't have to think about it.
I even overthought the truth. I have to write it down. Like, I was overthinking it. I couldn't even think about the truth of myself.
I told you, I'm going to pressure you. I'm really good at this.
All right. So 1 point for Jairus, mga kapamilya. Jai, your turn.
Okay. I love basketball. I love bikes. And I love playing soccer.
Which one is the lie?
Where is the lie?
It's one of the last two.
So kapag nasagot mo, it's a kind of chamba. Okay, sige. So which one?
repeat it.
Okay, so I love basketball. I love bike. I love soccer.
Soccer.
That's the lie. You think that's a lie?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yes.
You sure?
Yes.
Okay, tama, yun yung lie.
Yeah.
That's the lie.
you know what told me?
What?
It's when you looked really happy when you said, I love soccer.
Oh, being artista, no? Haya, no? Faking it. All right, let's see you on our last round. One more round. Your turn again, Haya.
Oh my god, I have to think about this again. Wait, make him go.
I'll go first.
All right.
I went to Japan. I went to Japan. I went to Qatar, and I went to Malaysia already.
Parang hirap na na. Japan, Qatar, and Malaysia.
I'm trying to remember what you told me in the past.
What if wala ako nasabi?
Because I know, I remember you were planning to go to Japan.
Uh-huh.
But I can't remember if you told me if you've been there before.
Mm-hmm.
Ayun.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So which one is the lie?
The Japan is happening in a couple of weeks, so I don't know.
Japan.
Japan is alive.
Everyone goes to Japan.
Okay, so yeah. So what's the answer? What do you think is a lie? Where's the lie?
Oh my god, I'm an overthinker too. Mario, Sip. I'm just gonna say it.
Okay.
Malaysia.
You sure?
Yeah.
No, that's a fact. I never went to Japan. It's my first time going to Japan in a couple of months. In a couple of weeks, yeah.
So it's my first right time in Japan. First time. I was right.
Yeah. Yeah. It's my first time in Japan this December. Yeah.
Guys, this is a sign to trust your intuition.
Totoo. All right. Haya, your turn.
Oh my god, wait, I forgot to think about this. Okay. I'll just see whatever comes up into my head.
That one. Ah, wala pa pala. Sorry, okay. Sorry. Akala ko meron.
My lola is the one who taught me how to braid my hair. My mm-hmm. mom is the one who taught me to do my makeup. And
oh my god. Too
my
personal.
My dad is the one who taught me how to cook.
Too wow. personal. That was too much. That was too personal. Oh my god. Oh my god. How would I know that? Anyway, okay, fine. I think the last one.
Sure?
Yeah, I'm sure. I'm really sure. Yeah, I'm sure. You don't give me that straight face. I'm sure.
Bumabawi siya, Jay.
Yeah, bumabawi siya. Just giving me that straight face. Come on. The last one. Oh, hell no. Okay, fine. Props to your dad. So what's the lie? Where's the lie?
My Lola's the one who taught me how to braid.
Who taught you?
YouTube.
Me.
And my
YouTube. Tutorials.
Oh, I got you back.
All right. So sorry, Jai.
It's a tie.
Pero ito naman, our next and last challenge, we'll call it your what if challenge. So I just have to say and read any statement here and just have to answer it. No pressure. Let's start with, what if may chance kang baguhin any mistakes from your past? Would you still change it? If yes, ano ito?
I don't know. I don't want to change anything since, you know, no regrets. Pero siguro if there's one thing that I want to change, siguro I should have handled my financial, my money early year. Parang sana mas na-handle ko siya nung una pa lang para, you know, mas naging wise ako sa pera. Pero syempre, bata pa naman ako noon. My mom handles mm-hmm. my money. Pero at least I had the opportunity to learn more about money. Yeah.
I want lang ba?
Sige, dagdag mo yan, Jai, kung meron pa.
And then siguro, syempre, yung mga ano natin, mga immature decisions natin, immature attitudes natin ng mga bata pa tayo na nagkaroon ng effect sa mga tao na sa paligid natin.
Right. I don't want to go into detail so much, but lately I have made a couple mistakes, or not even mistakes, but there were mm-hmm. things that I feel that I could have done better.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, I wouldn't want to fix them because everything that's happened in my life is what has helped me to get to know myself better. and to help myself heal and grow more, especially when it comes to like my maturity.
And,
you know, everything psychological and stuff like that.
Very matured mga kapamilya yung sagutan nilang dalawa. No? Tignan natin susunod. What if you're about to do your last project sa showbiz? Whether it's a series or a movie, what project would it be? Like, what genre and your role there?
I'm gonna be specific with Iron Man. Yun lang. Kasi sobrang idol ko si Iron Man. Something so-so-so kapag last na gusto ko Iron Man. Or at least an action movie na kind of may mga soldier movie yung parang mga Black Hawk Down, mga ganang klase movie, mga Hawksworld pa yun, yeah, something like that. Kasi yung mga 13 hours na mga movies, you know.
So action or Iron Man. Iron Man. Kaya for you.
It's hard to say since I'm just now
starting. I started.
Oo nga naman kasi naman. But... kakasimula pa lang yung last project
I
agad
know.
Natin.
But I guess it would just be to be in a TV series because I haven't had that yet. Yeah, it would be that. Any genre, as long as it's a TV series that I'd love to star in.
OG sa TV series talaga. Next, what if we can bring back time? What phase of your life you want to go back?
Super Ingo.
Childhood days, grabe.
Yeah. So, kung balikan yun, it was... ngayon, inisip ko, it was magical. Sobrang dali ng trabaho. Kala mo naglalaro pa lang. And it was super fun being with them, with the people around you, makisig ka rin. It was just pure fun. Pero nagtatrabaho ka na pala. So, yun yung gusto kong balikan.
Sorry, I just have to follow up. Hayano. Jay, that time ba, naiisip mo na or na naiintindihan mo na parang kumbaga Super Ingo, sikat na sikat sa mga kabata. All ages din siya na kumbaga artista ka, madaming humahanga sa'yo. Naiisip mo na ba yun that?
Hindi talaga. I was like this, I just go there na para bang I'm just asked to do it na hindi ko pa siya iniisip na work eh. Pero okay, punta ako doon kasi kinuha nila ako eh. Ito ako, I'm gonna do this. But at the same time, hindi ko naiisip yung kasi nag-enjoy ako. Kasama ko si Makisig, kasama ko si Katrin. Other friends namin dun sa showbiz, sila Andy, sila Jeff. Ito lang, tatrabaho lang ako. Naglalaro lang ako. And hindi ko naiisip yung people na, ganito pala kalaki yung impact niya sa tao, sa mga bata, sa mga matatanda. Ito na pala siya. Pero every time naman nalalabas kami, I've been really great and appreciative naman sa support at pagmamahal na pinapakita ng tao sa akin.
Galing.
Yeah.
Hi, Shin, for you.
I have two answers. One would also be when I was a child. You know, everything felt more pure and happy, and no matter what, how horrible the world was, you know, we still saw it as like a beautiful place where we had more freedom to practice like our creativity and stuff. But my second answer would also be the time that I moved to the Philippines. Just so I miss my family and friends back then, and I just wish that I was able to spend more time with them as I was saying goodbye.
Eto last, your personal what if, like yung kumbaga what if mo sa sarili mo na up until now dala-dala mo pa din.
These are some deep questions.
What if hindi ako artista? What if hindi ako artista, natuloy ko yung, like, I focus more on my basketball career and what, in now, what if I'm just a normal dude na nandyan lang sa labas, studying, playing basketball. What if hindi ako artista?
Pero Jay, do you consider being a basketball player your kumbaga alternate career if kumbaga hindi ka man artist ngayon?
Yeah, siguro if I also had that siguro yung parang nagkaroon ako ng ganung ka todo at ganung opportunity na mag-train when I was a kid na magkaroon ng iba't ibang opportunity na makapag-train ng maganda, ng ayos. Siguro yes, baka. Pero siguro kung nasan man ako ngayon in terms of my basketball career, hindi siguro, I'm basketball, how I play basketball, it was, hindi rin siguro sa maging posible, kundi rin sa mga tao na kilala ko sa showbiz, like Gerald Anderson, no, he, kasi nabigyan niya ako ng opportunity din somehow to, you know, yung mag-gym ako sa kanya, makasabay ko siya sa lahat, and yung people din na nakilala ko because of my celebrity games, yung mga professional basketball players, siguro hindi because of that opportunity nang dahil sa pag-artista ako. Baka hindi rin kayo yung opportunity ko before na hindi ako artista. So, yeah. Pero kinoconsider ko naman din siya.
Win-win situation pa rin for you talaga, di ba?
Yes.
Ayasin, for you, your personal what if?
I feel like I have so many.
As an overthinker, no?
Yeah. An overthinker. It's a lot of things. Like, what if I hadn't gone through a traumatic experience that changed my life when I was a child? Or what if I hadn't moved to the Philippines? What if I hadn't moved to Manila and I just stayed in Bacolod? I've been wondering a lot of things a lot, especially because I've been going through a lot of change right now. Because I've been moving, I'm still settling down, I'm still trying to find my sense of security. But I don't know if I should go into detail, but I wonder a lot of things.
Pero for sure, Haya naman, all of your decisions talaga will be worth it, maybe not now, but for sure in the future. Yeah. Lahat ng what ifs mo magkakaroon din ng answer, di ba? Pero yan na nga, that wraps up our what ifs challenge. And before we end, Jairus and Hyacinth, please once again invite our kapamilyas to watch out for your upcoming series. Go ahead.
Me first again. Okay. Hello, Poca Familia. I'm inviting you all to watch Chase Skies Archer on Vivo One, soon streaming on November 20. I'm excited.
So yeah, once again, mga kapamilya, inibitahan ko po kayo na panoorin ang Chase Skies Archer on November 20 sa Vivo One. And ayun, I hope to be with you again soon. Sa another cap chat or anywhere sa kapamilya. No? Sana makita-kita ulit tayo soon. Pero ayun, I hope na sana supportahan niyo talaga yung Safe Skies Archer and yung iba pang book sa darating. So, maraming salamat.
Yes. Ako, sana nga makasama natin si Hyacinth and si Jairus again sa studio naman ng Kapamilya Chat. And
yeah.
Praying and hoping for a TV series for the both of you, especially for Hyacinth. Ayun yung kumbaga dream niya din talaga. No? Pero again, thank you, Haya and Jai, for joining us this evening dito sa Kapamilya Chat. And to all our kapamilyas who tuned in from the very start until this moment, thank you guys so much. Once again, I'm Jeremiah with Hyacinth Caliada and Jairus Aquino. See you guys next week only here on Kapamilya Chat. Bye everyone and stay safe. Happy weekend.
Bye. Thanks guys.
Thank you.
Kapamilya Chat.